Websites. I've said before that the internet is a network for communicating. I said before that the World Wide Web is an application that runs on that network, and that application consists of browsers and servers serving all the world's information. That's ostensibly what the World Wide Web is about. That information is broken down by websites. Website is a convention that we created, a word that we created, website, to explain all the information that is more closely affiliated with itself internally than it is externally. So let me contrast websites with books. I've said before that the internet is like the replacement for the world's library. The World Wide Web is a replacement for the world's library. It's where our information now resides. And now, as a library has books, the web has websites. But there's a fundamental difference, and this is a really important difference. The book in a library makes references to other books, right? In the back you have a bibliography or something like that. It's loosely connected to all the other books of the world. A website, on the other hand, is not loosely connected to all the other sites of the world. It's directly connected to all those other sites. So the analogy would be, if I go into a library, a physical library, I take out a book, I turn to page 32 and it says, you know, there's more information about this in some other book. I put my finger on that part of the book and out flies another book from the shelves, lands on the table, open to the right page. Right, that's the kind of library that the World Wide Web is. And of course, it's a much larger library than any physical library ever invented. So the website is sort of like a book, but it's a book that's so drastically interconnected with all the other books on the web that it's sometimes hard to tell the difference where one ends and one begins. However, simply to keep us organized and to have us feeling like we're consuming the right information, we organize all the world's information, all the information on the World Wide Web, into these things called sites. Okay, so I want you to look at sites in a stranger way than you have before. You usually think of a site as just some place where I go to, I get some information from it, or, you know, I sign up for something or I buy something, whatever. What I want you to think of now is that sites are loose affiliations. They're conglomerations of information that shares more internally than it does to the outside world. But that's a gray line between what is internal and what is external. And a website could easily consume and deliver information from many, many, many different sites, many different sources altogether. So the idea of a site is much looser than the idea of a book.